Well, hello everybody. It's been 7 months, 7 months since I've done a video. I don't know why I'm not doing videos anymore. It's just, I don't know, I'm just busy and then so much time goes by and there's so much to show you or talk about and it's like, I don't know where to begin. So I've been prodded by a couple of people, you know who you are, to make a video. So here I am today, and I've got tons of stuff on this table to show you. I have notes, so because I had to look at my photos to see what I've been doing the past 7 months, so I can tell you about it, because you know what, you can't remember. So, okay, so back in July when we were on our trip, we got home about the middle of July, and we were home for about a week and a half, and then we went down to the beach, down to our place down in Port Aransas. And we were there for 2 weeks, and all the kids came down and grandkids, and they were just there for, I guess, 3 days, 3 days, 4 days. And we had a great time at the beach. And so we did that. So that was in the end of July. In August, we had my son's birthday, my grandson's birthday. I don't know, probably other stuff. July, August, September, October, November. What else do I have on here? Got home from the trip, went down to the beach. Oh, yeah. And when was that? In August. We had that hurricane. You know, for the life of me, I can't remember the name of it. Is it Harvey? I don't know. That's stupid. I might have to cut that out. But we had a hurricane, and our backyard, our dock, everything back there, well, the water came up from the lake halfway up our yard, and we're up way far from the lake, and we sit on a hill. So for it to come up as far as it did was really shocking. Anyway, my husband was out of town, of course. I mean, everything disastrous always happens when he's out of town. So he was out in Washington, Oregon, wherever, to see the total eclipse. Remember when that was going on? Well, he went out there with his hiking buddy and to see that, and to also do some hiking. And anyway, so I had my neighbor, he was home, thankfully, because he travels a lot with his job, and he was home and he helped me tie the boat down, because once the water came up, you know, the boat was gonna float up off of the lift, whatever. So he helped me tie it down, or I should say he tied it down. Well, I think we tied the back end too tight, and the back end wasn't able to rise with the water, and it flooded. And so anyway, we had to have that repaired. We had a lot of damage to the awnings at the dock. The jet skis were okay. We had a few boards to replace on the dock itself, but all in all, we were pretty lucky compared to the devastation that happened here in Houston, and it was just unbelievable, the damage that was done, and the people who lost their houses, and everything, and it was horrible. So all in all, we were pretty fortunate and lucky. So, okay, so we survived through that, and then we had Thanksgiving. My son in South Carolina and his family came, and my daughter-in-law's parents and her brother came also. So all together for Thanksgiving, we had 19 people. And I loved it. I loved it. I had the whole family here. And I cooked the biggest turkey I could find, a fresh one. I don't buy the frozen ones. I bought a fresh turkey. I think it was 22, 23 pounds. And then we bought another turkey. And my husband, since I only have one oven, my husband smoked the other turkey. And it turned out really good. And we had a great meal. And we had a lot of fun. And it was great visiting with everybody. All the grandkids got to play. And you know, because they don't see the ones in South Carolina very often, so they got to play with them, and everybody got reacquainted, all the little kids, you know, and it was so much fun. We had a great time, but it was over all too soon. So then we had December, Christmas, actually before Christmas. We went on a trip to Canton, which is up near Dallas, Texas. And they have a thing there called First Monday, and it's the first weekend, it's the weekend of the first Monday every month. And it's, actually they started having it on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And so we decided to go and meet our friends that used to be our neighbors in Baton Rouge, and then again in Texas here, and now they live a couple hours from us. So, and they're our RV friends. We go RVing with them occasionally. We don't anymore because since my husband retired, we have totally different schedules. They're morning people, and we're not. So they wouldn't like waiting till around 10 or 11 to go out each day when they're up at, 5:30, 6 o'clock, and they're ready to go by 8. We're just getting up at 8, so we don't travel together anymore, but except occasionally we'll take a short weekend trip together. But anyway, and that was one of these. And so we went up there, and what First Monday is, it's a huge, huge flea market, and they have, typical flea market stuff. They have new stuff. They have crafts, arts and crafts, all kinds of stuff, lots of food. And the place is huge. You can't even hardly see it all in a weekend. And they also have a place up there that a lot of the people call Dogtown. They have lots of animals, and not just dogs and puppies, but cats and chickens and sheep and goats and pigs and all kinds of things, up there. Well, our friends, her husband Andy, they go there more often than we do. He always goes to Dogtown and looks at the dogs. And so we were gonna go look at the dogs. And I told my husband, I'm not looking to get a dog. I don't know that I want a dog yet or at all, because I have been grieving over Scooty, ever since he died, for the past year. And every time I think of him, I get tears. And it was hard. It was, his death took a toll on me. See, I'm tearing up right now. Anyway, so we went there, and we were looking at all the little puppies and stuff, and I was kind of looking at the Maltese dogs, because when I got Scooter, I wanted to get a Maltese, but I couldn't be guaranteed that it was going to stay small, and I didn't want a big dog. I didn't want one over like 10 pounds, and some of the ones I saw were like 20, so anyway, so we were looking, and they were cute and, fluffy and white and so cute and adorable, and I put them back. And I told my husband, if I were to get a dog, it would have to just grab a hold of me right immediately, Well, then I saw we got puppies. Well, not just one, but two. It's a brother and a sister. I named them Jack and Jill. They're teeny tiny little Yorkies, and they're the sweetest, cutest thing ever. They have helped heal my heart, and they make me laugh every day. Mm-hmm. I'm having trouble potty training them because it's been so freezing cold, and they're so tiny. They're just 2 pounds right now. They're 5.5 months old, and but they're doing pretty good with the puppy pads, and it's more hit these days than miss, so I'm thankful for that. And let me see if I can grab them and show them to you. They're right here.
Come here. Come here, babies.
Uh-oh. So here they are. Aren't they the cutest? This is Jack. He's a little boy, as you can see. And this is Jill. Yeah, this is my Jack and Jill. And they're just, she is the most loving puppy ever. She always wants to be held, and well, not always, but she'll let me hold her whenever I want to, and she'll lay in my lap and take a nap. But him, he holds back, and if I try to reach down and grab him, he usually runs, although he's getting a little bit better. Wednesday, I've bathed them a couple of times since we've had them. I took them to a groomer. My vet has a groomer that comes to their office every Wednesday, And so I scheduled to have them groomed for the first time. And I told them, I said, they're going to be squirmy because when I just even try to brush them, they bite me and they squirm and, you know, there's no way. So anyway, I left them and 2 hours later, she called me. She said, they're done. She said, I wasn't able to use the shaver on them. And she trimmed around their face a little, did their little visor, which is the hair right above their eyes. And trimmed their toenails and tipped their ears, the hair on the tip of their ears, like I asked her to. But she said, you know, she's not able to use the shaver on them yet. They're just too squirmy. So in the meantime, I'm gonna have to be playing with their feet and getting them used to their feet being touched and try brushing them every day. And, right? So give me kisses? To give me kisses? Yeah. So anyway, they keep me busy. Mm-hmm. Since getting them, I've lost 8 pounds. After Scooter died, I had no reason to go outside. I was sitting on the couch knitting every day, doing nothing. Was depressed, you know. I had no reason to go out. I wouldn't even go out and get the mail because Scooter wasn't there to go with me. And but since getting these dogs, oh my God, I'm up and down constantly. I'm on the floor, I'm off the floor, I'm walking, I'm finding them, checking for accidents, you know, and I've lost 8 pounds, so yay. Anyway, it was touch and go with Jack for a while. When we first got home, he was very lethargic and he wouldn't eat that day. And he could barely hold his head up. So I told my husband, I said, we've got to take him to the emergency vet. It was a Sunday, of course. So we took him in. It was around 10 o'clock at night. And they immediately took some blood and checked his blood sugar, and they couldn't even get a reading. And so they put an IV and gave him glucose and they kept him overnight on an IV, and he perked up and he was okay. And they told me these puppies at that time, they weighed just under 1 pound. They weighed like 9.92, you know, and they were tiny. And right now they weigh 2.42 and 2.46, I think. I forget which one weighs a little bit more. But anyway, so they're about 2.5 pounds. And they're almost 6 months old. And but he was okay. And she told me that these puppies this small, they need to eat every 2 to 3 hours, around the clock almost. And she said, unfortunately, these breeders, where I got them, she said that unfortunately, they tend to only feed these puppies, you know, once a day or something, as little as possible to keep them small, because the smaller the puppy, the more money they make. So I hated that. I hate that I got another dog there, because I'm sure they probably came from a puppy mill, you know. And but I feel like if I hadn't adopted these two, Jack probably would have died, because maybe whoever else might have bought him wouldn't have taken care of him the way we did. So I felt like I did rescue them. Anyway, so they've been exciting and fun and a lot of work. So then we had Christmas, and that was good. Cole wasn't here because he was at his mom's this Christmas, but Lawrence was here. So we had a great Christmas. And after that, on the 28th, on my husband's birthday actually, we left to go to Atlantis in the Bahamas. We had the best time. We took the whole family, so it was everybody plus my son's girlfriend and her 3 kids. Had everybody. We had 16 of us on this trip. We had the best time. We were there for a week. We left on the 28th and we got back January 2nd. And we had the best time. And I was worried about having puppies, you know. It was a bad time to get puppies, and when we had this trip planned and everything was in place for that. But I found a pet sitter, and she stayed the night here at my house. She stayed here the whole time we were gone. She did leave to go to her job, which she worked 4 hours a day, three of the days that she was here. And she used to be a tech at a veterinarian clinic, and one of the ones actually that I used to go to. So I felt very at ease leaving the puppies with her, and because she knew everything about them and what to do. She could take their temperature and do all that kind of stuff. So anyway, they did really good, and so I didn't have to worry. She sent me little videos almost daily of them playing and stuff, so it worked out really good. So anyway, so we had that. Also in January, we had our 48th wedding anniversary, and he wasn't home. He left January 22nd. He's on another hiking trip with his friend, this time on a really, really long one. He won't be back till March the 8th. They are in New Zealand, and the last week of their trip, they're going to be in Australia. So he's having a great time, although I'm sure exhausting. They've been having a lot of rain too, which hasn't helped on some of the hikes they've been on. But they are with the REI group. They have a couple of tours scheduled with them, and then they have some that they're doing on their own. And they're having a great time. He calls me when he can, when he has a good signal or whatever. And so he called last night. He's growing a beard because he decided not to shave the whole 6 weeks he's gone, or however long it is. 10 weeks? I don't know. 6 weeks, I guess. So anyway, so that catches you up with what's been going on here. The other thing I wanted to do is show you some of the things I've been working on. In my last video, back in July, I was working on a shawl. And I finished it. And it's smaller than I thought it was going to be. And here it is. It turned out pretty nice. I mean, I like it. I could wear it around my neck, you know, especially on these cold days. It's like 30 something today. What is it? Let me see. It is, well, it's 43 degrees right now. But it was like 30 something when I got up this morning, and it's only a high of 49, which is cold for us. So I could wear it like this. And I love the colors of it, the red and the orange, and it gradually gets darker as you go down. So I had fun knitting this. The yarn is so soft and squishy, and it's just great. I love it. So it's in my drawer with all my knitted stuff. I also finished this sweater. Do you remember this that I showed you? Well, I finished it, and it fit, and I love it. The only thing is, I'm thinking about making some pockets for it, and some patch pockets or something, and adding them, because, you know, I think I'd like some pockets. So this is the sweater. I love it. It's just one to throw on, you know, when you're at the movies. It doesn't have any buttons or anything. And so I love it. I love it. Anyway, so there's that. Finish that. I was also working on some socks at that time. They were by some yarn called Zauer Ball or something like that. It's by this kind. And I had bought it. It's not this one, it's another one. I had bought it to make some socks, and because someone had told me that, oh, you're going to love that yarn. It is so great. You know, it's beautiful colors. You're going to love it. Well, I wasn't loving it. I didn't even like knitting with it. It didn't change colors often enough, and I got bored with it. And anyway, so here's the socks. They turned out great. They don't match, of course, because there's no way to match that kind of yarn, because it doesn't repeat at all, as you can see. These are my favorite socks. Who knew? You know, these are so great. I love them. So every time they're in my drawer, well, they don't stay there long, because they're usually on my feet or in the hamper, or they're drying on the laundry basket in the back or in the laundry room, because I love them. Anyway, so there's my socks. And I have another ball of that. I'm going to make some more, because I really ended up liking them. Let's see. That I was doing a knit along at one time, and I had showed you in one of my videos a partial when I was knitting on it. Remember this, the one with the sheep on the back, the baby sweater? Well, I finished it, and of course it's too small for my granddaughter. I don't know anybody that'll fit it. My sister's daughter just had a baby actually yesterday, but she had a boy, so I don't have anybody to give it to. So I'm just gonna hang on to it, and who knows, you know, someday I might know somebody that has a little infant, because this is like a 3 month size, newborn to 3 months or something like that. It's kind of little. It looks bigger on the camera, but it's really pretty small. So anyway, but I loved it, and it was so easy to knit, and I learned so many things doing that knit along, because up until this sweater, I had been doing top-down sweaters. Like this sweater is a top-down and no seams, you know, it has like raglan sleeves, and so you don't knit them separately and then sew it on. This one though, you knit the sleeve separately and you seam it, and you attach it with a seam, and you have the shoulder seams, and each one that each seam that there was to do, the instructor had you do it in a different way. Each one was a different. So I learned all different kinds of techniques, and it was really great. So I love doing this knit along. Look at these buttons. Are they not too cute? They're little sheep. I just loved them. Anyway, so that's the sweater. Too bad it didn't fit winter. She's now two. Do you believe it? Another thing I had worked on is this little hippo. I love it. I love doing little toys like this. I think I had showed you a monkey that I had made in one of my videos on our vacation that I gave to Winter, and a dinosaur that I gave to Ephraim, and a little Yoda that I had given to Bright. But anyway, I love making these little toys. So there was a pattern, you know, from the knitting podcast that I watch on YouTube. One of the girls had made this. It was just so cute. So I had to get the pattern, and I had to get the yarn, and so I made him, and I just love him, and I didn't give him to anybody. I kept him. Another thing I made, this little egg here. It's a topsy-turvy toy by Susan B. Anderson, and this is an egg to an owl, and I had so much fun knitting this, and I just love it. And again, I haven't given this to anybody, but here it is. It's the egg, and you turn it inside out. And it's an owl. Is that not the cutest thing? And it just sits there. Look at that. It's so cute. Oh my gosh. That's his little feet. and his little wings. His ears. He's just so cute. And then when you're done playing with him, just send him back in his little egg. There he is. Love it. Love it. So, since I like working on those little things, I'm now making another one called A Little Giraffe, and it's also by Susan B. Anderson. Her patterns are just great because they're done with no seaming. Everything is knit in as you go, the arms and legs and everything, and it makes it so easy to do because you don't have to sew anything on. Let me show you. I'm making this little giraffe here. I'm doing mine in a different color though. And I'm using this yarn and this, and then here's my progress so far. I just got to the, I'm on the bottom. You do the legs first, and then you start with the bottom. And that starts with the color work, you know, that green and white. Those, what were they? Those shapes? Let me look. Anyway, let me see if I can find a picture again. Right here. So, has a little bit. It's in this magazine called Making. And this is the third edition called Dots. And this is a magazine, but it's actually like a book. It's a book, and it has stories in it, and it has some patterns, and It's a great little thing full of, and different designers and stuff. Different designers contribute patterns, and Susan B. Anderson tends to contribute a pattern in each issue. So I subscribed to it, and I have 2, 3, and 4, and I just yesterday subscribed to 5 and 6 for this year. There's only 2. It comes out in the spring and then again in the fall. And anyway, great. So making that, what else am I doing? I'm sure you're just dying to know, aren't you? Christmas Eve, I decided to cast on a pair of socks because everybody cast on Christmas Eve socks. So this was mine. This was my yarn. This was my Christmas Eve sock. I haven't blocked this or washed it or anything yet. I just took it off the needles, and this is the first one. And I have started the second one, but I've only gotten this far so far. But, you know, I haven't been working on it much. And I get bored easily. And this sock doesn't really, I didn't do any pattern. It's just a plain sock, just, you know, the cuff and then the knit and kiss lips, fish heel. I do, and then the toe, no pattern, so it's kind of mindless knitting, and I get bored really easy. Another thing, I was in my yarn shop one time in the fall, and I sat and knit with some of the people in there. I had the best time. Oh my God, it was so much fun. Anyway, they had this shawl, not a shawl, it was a scarf, like an infinity scarf, hanging on a thing on display. And it was the softest yarn and so light and airy, like a feather. And it had little sequins on it, and it was so cool. Turns out it was made out of mohair. This. The one they had in the shop was white. And but of course they didn't have any more white or cream color, so I ended up with this color. Because I figure, you know, that's my color, that rust. You know, so I've been working on it. It knits on the bias, which means you cast on a certain amount and then you knit one and then increase one, and then at the other end you knit to the last 3 stitches and you knit 2 together and knit 1. So it gives you like a curved edge, but when you sew it all together it just makes an infinity scarf. The bottom, it's the first time I did a provisional cast on, which is a cast on with some scrap yarn, which then at the end you take that off, you grab those stitches. What it does is just holds those live stitches there at the end, and then you put your needle back in all these stitches, you take off this waste yarn and the end from the other one, and then you graft it together, and so it makes it kind of seamless. And so that's cool. So I've been working on that too. So that's all my I have one more project. I did another knit along back in the fall. It was through Craftsy. And if you're not familiar with Craftsy and you're a knitter or a crocheter, you need to check it out. Or a baker or a sewer or anything. They have video classes on just about anything. They're not free. You have to buy whichever class you want. I just recently bought one for drawing. I want to learn how to draw these little cartoon characters. I don't know why, I just do. So, and it was on sale. It was only like $14.99 for the whole program, and you have it forever. You can go back and look at it and watch the videos forever, and it's really great. So there are tons of videos on there. So anyway, there was a knit along, and I decided to join it, and it was by Bristol Ivy. And it is a sweater. I don't think I have the pattern in here. So I can't show it to you what it looks like. Anyway, I'm making it. My yarn is brown. It's my needles. Let me take my needles out of there and show you. This is the bottom. It's lace. And it has a pocket. You see my pocket right here? Right here? It's a pocket. It's not sewed together on the inside yet. You do that towards the end. But the bottom part has lace, and then you're doing the stockinette the stockinette stitch here, and that goes up till you get to the up here by the arms, and then you have your shoulder seams and the neck and the sleeves. And so of course I'm at the boring part where it's just stockinette, just knit and purl, knit and purl, knit one row, purl back. And I got bored, so I set it aside, and that's when I started the giraffe. So I keep busy, you know, I like my knitting. I was in a slump there for a while and I wasn't knitting at all. And that's the first time it had ever happened to me. And I don't know what was wrong. I just, you know, didn't feel like knitting. I don't know. I blame it on Scooter and Scooter dying. So this is 30 minutes long already. And, you know, that's not bad for not having done a video in 7 months. And I had a lot to show you and tell you. And I think, where's my notes? They got buried in all the stuff. I think that's all I had to say. Did I tell you we had our 48th wedding anniversary? 48 years. Oh my God. Thanksgiving puppies, Jack and Jill. Isn't that a cute name? I should have named him Tater Tot. If I would have thought of it, I would have. I wanted to name them Lucy and Ethel, but, I mean, not Lucy and Ethel, Lucy and Ricky, but, my son said, well, Lucy and Ricky were husband and wife, and these are brother and sister, you can't name them that. So, anyway, we came up with Jack and Jill. So, I like Jack. I'm not too thrilled with Jill's name. I call her Jilly, but, and I call him Jax a lot of times, so... Anyway, so that's my puppies, but I'm so glad I got them, and I don't know how big they're going to get. The vet thinks they're going to top out at maybe 4 pounds, so that's smaller than what Scooter was. And but the reason I'm not taking them out so much, like I started to tell you earlier, was that, you know, they're so tiny, and they didn't have any sweaters small enough, and I hadn't knit them one, and I tried a sock, but it was too tight, and I needed to get one of my husband's socks, but I just didn't, and I didn't want to take them out because we were having this freezing weather, and I didn't want them to get sick again. And so anyway, they're going on the puppy pads, and they're doing pretty good, but I am taking them out now. We have some fencing, some chicken wire stuff. My husband, it was about 24 inches, and he cut it in half and put it together, and then we sectioned off a section of grass out here by the patio so that I could put them out there, and so they can't get through the wrought iron fence that divides me and my neighbor's yards, and so that they can't get down to the lake area where the dock is. And 'cause, you know, they're terriers, you know, Yorkshire Terriers. They'll probably jump right in the lake or into the pool. I don't know. They're just little puppies. They don't know any better. So we did that, and that's been working out great. I'll take them out there, and they'll play, and they'll fight, and they'll chase each other, and finally pee or poop. And but Jill, she's a little devil. I'm telling you, she has learned to jump over the fence already. So she hops over it. So I got to watch her, because there's only one little section where she likes to jump over it, and I just have to watch her. And now I don't even have to say anything. I just have to move, and she knows, and she goes away from it. We had to put barricades across our bedroom doorway. Now, I don't use a gate because they're tall, and Mikey, my cat, he has arthritis, and he can't jump over that gate. Molly can, but he can't. And they like to go in my bedroom or bathroom during the day to sleep, to just get away from people if anybody comes over, or even the puppies. And so I wanted them to be able to get in there. So my husband took some pegboard, and he cut pieces about this tall, put it across the doorway there, and in the office, the two rooms that we have carpet, where I didn't want them to be. And didn't take Jill long, and she was hopping over that. So he had to raise up the one. He raised it up some, and she can still get over it. So now I have to pull the door almost all the way closed, and that keeps her from trying to jump over it, but it also enables Mikey to go over it if he wants to. So that's working for now. But she has, you know, sometimes I forget to pull the bedroom door closed, and she ends up going in there, you know, and I go and I'm looking and there's Jack, but no Jill, and then there she is in my bedroom. And don't you know, she went in the bathroom and then she pooped and anyway, and the same thing with the office, you know, we don't want them on that carpet in there. Now I have some old, an old area rug, you know, like a Persian rug, but it's not, that we used to have in our living room. We have bought a new rug for our living room back last January, not this January. And, we put the old one in our dining room, and then I have another one of those type of rugs in my foyer area right by the dining room. And I'm and Scooter and Casey, my other dog, they used to have accidents on that rug, and I've had it shampooed and everything, but I'm sure, you know, it probably still has some kind of dog scent on it. And we were just using it temporarily anyway in the dining room. Well, I'm sure the dogs go out there all the time, and I'm sure they pee out there a lot. I don't know. So when they're done being trained, I'm just going to toss the rugs. Those two, anyway, toss those rugs. Get the one in the new one in our living room, because she has peed on it a couple of times. I caught her. Even though you blot it up and rinse it with water and stuff, you know, still, I'm going to have to shampoo those rugs once I get them trained, if I get them trained. It is so hard. I forget how to do it. We had a doggy door when Scooter was little. And I don't remember training him. You know, it was like 14 years ago. I don't remember puppy training, potty training, house training, whatever you call it. So anyway, you kind of get to know when they need to go. I try not to say anyway. I notice that I say that a lot. So, I'm going to try harder. Well, I hope that catches you up on me and my life. My health has been great. I've been doing good, feeling good. My checkups have been good. I don't go back again until like May for another CT scan and endoscopy to make sure that nothing's growing back. And but I've been doing good. My heart's good, as far as I know. The doctor took me off my heart medication, and he just increased my baby aspirin. So now instead of one a day, I take two a day. But I'm doing good. I feel good. I'm losing some weight due to the puppies, which is always a bonus. And, things are good. So, okay. Well, I'm going to go 37 minutes. I'm sorry. It's so long. And I'll talk to you again. Hopefully it won't take 7 months for me to do another video. And, I'll talk to you again later. Bye. Thanks for watching.